Do you want to be more productive? Do you always feel too busy and stressed? Do you think time management is outdated? Well, you need to work on attention management. Hello everyone, my name is Haritosh and today I'm going to present to you the big book review of Attention Management. This book, Attention Management, is written by Maura Neville Thomas. Maura is an award-winning speaker, trainer, and author of multiple books. Her work on attention management is most cited. Now, this book is part of Ignite Reads, which are short book collection for an hour or less reading by leading experts and are known for their captivating content. Well, this book is just over 100 pages and actual content is only about 90 pages. What I like about this book is this is full of colored pages, images, and infographics. Apart from introduction and conclusion, there are only 5 chapters and each followed by some action steps. So very, very interesting book. And now let's dig deep into individual chapters. The introduction starts by talking about why is it important for all the distractions to capture our attention. It's no longer about time, it's about capturing the attention of audience. If you look at all the social media ads, emails, etc., etc., they all are trying to distract you, to capture your attention so that you spend more time on that. In fact, she says that the real truth about internet and digital distraction is that the job of internet is to keep you on the internet. Your addiction is the ultimate goal of any new app, any new website. So how you manage your time is only relevant to the extent that you devote your attention. In the end of the chapter, she talks about attention management and what it feels like to have your attention properly managed. Chapter 1 talks about what is attention management. She digs deep into the concept, the whole concept of attention management, where she says that it is a collective practice of a group of behavior. She says there are 4 different quadrants that we spend our time on. Number 1 is reactive plus distracted, where we react to things, we are distracted, and we are not really productive. Number 2 is the state of flow. Now it's getting very popular now, where you forget all other things, you concentrate and you do one thing and you feel really, really good about it. Number 3 is the daydreaming, where you are literally not doing anything, you are relaxing. And she says it is one of the very important aspects that we are doing daydreaming and we are not distracted by any of the attention seeking apps. And the 4th is the focused and mindful state, where you consciously make effort to focus on the task. You put your attention on task, and if there are distractions come, you consciously take it out of your attention. So as she says that it is all about how much time you spend on each quadrant, and more importantly, how much you want to spend on each quadrant. In the chapter 2, attention management problem undermine your success, she talks about all the common situations that sabotage our productivity and attention management. She talks about what are the different types of distractions that take over us. It's people, technology, environments. And she also talks about the unproductive culture we all have seen across, like email expectation. Your boss sends you an email and you need to reply even before he sends it. Evaluating people based on how much time you spent in office and busyness over productiveness. Like, I am so busy even though I'm not doing any meaningful work. And result of all this distraction and unproductive culture is that you feel burned out, you feel exhausted. In the next chapter, Starting Your Journey with Attention Management, Laura takes us to the different aspects that we can use to improve our productivity. Number 1 is controlling your technology, and she talks about phone, email and notification. We need to, probably when we are trying to focus or we want to have pure attention, then we need to switch off or put at least on do not disturb the phone. Then for emails, we should put it on download on demand, and we should close the email client when not required. Most of office goers have their Outlook and other Lotus Notes, etc. open all the time, and all the notification that we get distracts us. And lastly, she talks about all the phone notifications. She says that shut off all notification except the emergency one, like the call, the message, and maybe WhatsApp. The second thing she talks about is controlling your environment. She says that if you're trying to focus and you do not want any disturbance, then put a physical do not disturb sign if you are in a office space or if you are even in at your home. And she also talks about why it is important to remove or manage the clutter in your workspace. It's very important that we have a specific place for our work, and if for any specific task we focus on that when we do not have any clutter or anything. So very, very good suggestions here on how we can improve and how we can start on with the journey of attention management. Next, chapter 4 is about how can you master attention management. She talks about controlling the habits and controlling the thoughts. Controlling habits require that you set focused time slots for doing things. You give yourself some quick, quiet time where you do not play with technology. You also practice mindfulness, or you can try with meditation, taking some time off and taking regular breaks and holidays. That can help set up your habits for success. And the next point is controlling your thoughts, and where she talks about having a workflow management system, a systematic way where you keep all your tasks at one place so that our thoughts do not disturb when we are trying to focus on one particular task. She also seeks that you should get into the flow and go to the depth. Many a times we look at the surface, we look at top 5, top 10 things, but we do not go into the depth, and that does not allow us to get into the state of flow. So those were two major things in the chapter, how to master attention management. The chapter 5, set yourself for success with attention management, goes even deeper by giving you some tips and tricks on how you can train your mind to work on attention management. That primarily includes how do you prioritize rest, how do you eat nutritious food, you get outside, exercise, etc., etc. She also talks about some belief in bad habits that we all have. For example, multitasking is good. It is not. Constantly checking emails is good. It is not. And having all the alerts and notification is good. It is not. So this is where she trains that we can train our mind to go deeper in the attention management. The last one is the conclusion, where she concludes by saying attention management is the single most important skill for true productivity. If you can control your attention, you can control your life. So it's a wonderful book, and I will definitely recommend that you go through the book. It is not too costly as well, and I was able to complete this book in one go in about an hour or so. So whatever it promises, it delivers. I learned so many things, and now I'm very, very conscious about my attention and how different distractions are seeking my attention. So definitely a worthy read for you. Please go and check it out. I would also like to shout out to all the 11-12 people who said yes when I asked whether they want me to do the book review. So thank you guys, thank you so much. So until next time, keep learning, keep growing, and keep going out of your comfort zone. Thank you so much.